Hey SNC Kids, welcome back to another episode of SNAKS. I just wanted to let you know of our two kids quests that we have going on at the moment. So the first one is, when Jesus spoke to the woman at the well, what did he say he could give her? That's the first one. And the second one is, what does it mean that Jesus was the Messiah? So grab out your Bibles, go reading, go find them. First up in today's episode, I'm going to be showing you how to make your at-home teachers, aka your mums and dads, the most amazing coffee. Firstly, you will need your brother or sister, or maybe your mum or your dad to help you, because we are going to use some appliances in the kitchen and we want you to stay safe. So, firstly, you'll want to grab yourself a mug. This is my personal favorite mug. You can go find your mum or dad's favorite mug too. Secondly, you'll need some milk. I've got full cream milk, but if your parents like that other kind of milk, like almond or soy, you can grab that too. Thirdly, you will need the coffee. Now, if your parents don't like coffee, replace it all with tea. But I'm gonna make coffee because it's the morning and so we gotta start the day with some coffee. And then thirdly, when you find your older brother or sister or your parents to help you, you are going to get the kettle and you're going to fill it up with water and set it to boil. So let's jump into it. So here is my setup. I have my kettle that has been boiled. I have my cup, a spoon for stirring, the coffee and the milk. So firstly, you're going to want to get your coffee, and however strong your mums or dads like it, put in a teaspoon. Then, using your older brother or sister or your mum, we're going to carefully, because this is very, very hot, pour the hot water into a cup like this. Now, once that's done, don't fill it all the way up to the top because we've got to add some milk. I like to give that a good stir. Can you see? I'm incorporating the coffee and the hot water. Then we're going to grab our milk and we're going to give a little splash of milk, like so. If your mums or dads like more milk, add more milk. And you're going to want to keep stirring. And then there you go. That is one amazing coffee that your mums and dads are going to love. Remember to pack everything up for them and carefully walk this over. If you want to grab your brother or sister, maybe help you carry it because it is going to be a bit hot, that'd be a good idea too. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Moses stood up and asked Jesus the question to see what he would say. What must I do to have eternal life? Jesus answered, "What is written in the scriptures?" said the man replied. "The scriptures say, love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, strength and mind. They also say, love your neighbors as much as you love yourself." "You have given the right answer," said Jesus. If you do this, you will have eternal life." But the man wanted to show that he knew what he was talking about. So he asked Jesus, "Who are my neighbors?" Jesus answered by telling the story.
As a man was going down from Sydney to Campbelltown, robbers attacked him and grabbed everything he had. They beat him up and ran off, leaving him half dead.
Ouch, ouch.
Yinny Kitty happened to be going down the same road. But when she saw the man, she walked past on the other side. Later, a policeman came to the same place. But when he saw the man who had been beaten up, he also went past on the other side. A Gotham City guy then came travelling along that road. When he saw the man, he felt sorry for him and went over to him. He treated his wounds with olive oil and wine and bandaged them. Then he put him on his stolen trailer and took him to an inn where he took care of him. The next morning he gave the innkeeper 2 silver coins and said, "Please take care of the man. If you spend more than this on him, I will pay you when I return."
Then Jesus asked, "Which of these 3 people are a real neighbor to the man who was beaten up by robbers?" Then the expert replied, "The one who showed pity." Jesus said, "Go and do the same."
And now, the moment you've been waiting for. Let's hear the answer to this month's Kids Quest. The answer to the first question was, when Jesus spoke to the woman at the well, he said that he could give her living water. And the answer to the second question, what does it mean that Jesus was the Messiah? Well, it meant that he had to come to fulfill God's promise to save Israel and eventually the entire world. If you got those right this month, congratulations! Stay tuned to hear our Kids Quest for August.
Hi kids! Welcome to my kitchen! Today, I'm going to be baking some cookies. Because snacks is all about snacks, right? So, in here, I have my cookie dough. I have to add an egg. And I have to add some butter. And then, we're going to bake butter a little bit so it's soft. I'm going to pop it in my bowl. And then I've got an egg. Crack the egg in the bowl. Baking is often about a word called patience. And that's what I'd like to talk to you about today. And it kind of means waiting. Have you ever had your mum and dad say, "Wait patiently"? Yeah. Wait, be patient. Wait for dinner. Wait till your brother's finished on the game and you can have your turn. Be patient. Baking is all about patience as well. So it takes time. Now I'm mixing and mixing and mixing. Did you know that God talks about patience being something that we can grow over time? By spending time with Holy Spirit in prayer, practicing patience, we can grow it like other fruits of the Spirit, like love or joy or peace. Not that big, maybe? There, another one. There it goes. Ooh. This is the interesting bit. Now I have to read the instructions, and it says, bake for 15 to 20 minutes. Oh, that's a really long time to wait. Here you go. Look at those delicious cookies. Do you think that they were worth the wait? I think that they were worth the wait. You know, the Bible says that we actually have to wait patiently for Jesus as well. In Titus, in the Bible, it says that we wait patiently for the hope that Jesus Christ is coming back to take us into heaven, into all eternity with Christ. See you later, kids!
Hey, Strong Nation kids, how's it going? Right now, I'm on the trampoline, as you can see, because it is a beautiful afternoon and I want to spend it outside and it's so much fun. I'm here to deliver to you your kids' quest for this month. Just one second. Don't try that at home, kids, unless you're a professional like myself. Okay, so last month we talked about the woman at the well in our kids' quest and about Jesus being the Messiah. But this month, our kids' quest has to do with the story of Jesus feeding the crowds, specifically the 5,000. So here it is, here's the big question. How many bread and fish did Jesus use to feed the 5,000? Now that's question number one. And if you want a bit more of a challenge, here's question number two. How many bread and fish did Jesus use to feed the 4,000? Which is another story found in some parts of the Bible. So there, your kids' quest for this month. Get reading into the Bible. I'll give you a hint. It's in the New Testament where Jesus is found. And see if you can find the answer to both of those questions. I'll catch you guys later. Whoop!